celebrating contributions by women to space exploration, a spotlight on the leading role of women in our Artemis program, and views from the space station of Hurricane Dorian. A few of the stories to tell you about this week at NASA. In celebration of Women's Equality Day on August 26th, we recognized the contributions of women to space exploration. For Ari Christina Cook, it also marked the 164th day in space and the midway point of what is expected to be a record-setting stay on board the International Space Station by the time she returns to Earth in February 2020. August 26th was also the 101st birthday of legendary NASA mathematician Katherine Johnson, who, along with many other human computers, performed critical calculations that helped our nation's space program get off the ground. Our Administrator Jim Bridenstine participated in a Women's Equality Day event during a visit to our Ames Research Center in California. It was an opportunity to highlight women leaders and to discuss our Artemis program, which will put the first woman on the moon within the next 5 years. House Speaker Nancy Pelosi, U.S. Representative Anna Eshoo, and others also attended the event. The administrator also toured the nearby facilities of NASA partner Made in Space, a company that has developed 3D printers used on board the International Space Station and is also developing technologies that could support our Moon to Mars exploration effort. Cameras outside the International Space Station captured views of Hurricane Dorian on the afternoon of August 29th as it turned over the Atlantic Ocean north of Puerto Rico. At the time, the storm was moving northwest at about 13 miles an hour and was predicted by the National Hurricane Center to approach the east coast of Florida around Labor Day as a possible Category 4 hurricane. A busy week of spacecraft maneuverings at the International Space Station, just before midnight Eastern Daylight Time on August 25th, three station crew members, including our Andrew Morgan, relocated a Soyuz spacecraft from one docking port to another. The vacated port was then used the following day for the successful docking of an uncrewed Soyuz on its second attempt to dock to the station. It arrived with 1,450 pounds of cargo for the station crew. Also on the move, a SpaceX Dragon resupply spacecraft left the space station on August 27th for its return to Earth. The Dragon, which arrived at the station about a month earlier, safely splashed down off the coast of Long Beach, California, with almost 2,700 pounds of valuable scientific experiments and other cargo. We are recruiting help from students around the country to come up with a name for our next Mars rover mission. The Mars 2020 Name the Rover Essay Contest is open to entries from K through 12 students in U.S. public, private, and home schools, with one grand prize receiving an invitation to see the mission launch in July 2020 from Cape Canaveral Air Force Station in Florida. For complete contest and prize details, visit go.nasa.gov/name2020. That's what's up this week at NASA. For more on these and other stories, follow us on the web at nasa.gov/twan.